Put these on today, day off work. My last day's holiday of this year, actually. I get a week off for Christmas anyway. So we have cash rules, MPS2, money belts, original £3 jackpot, MPS2. You've all seen these before, but you know what I'm like. Nudge Fever, a BWB rebuild of possibly money belt, cash rules, or a number of other machines. Money Matrix, another BWB, 1987 in fact. Rebuild of possibly money belt, cash fours, one or two other games. Oh no, actually it can't be because it's got the two buttons there. I don't know. Whatever, loot shoot or whatever. No, it's wrong. Frames, I don't know. Anyway, it'll tell you in the instruction. But spinner reel running MPS1. Rebuild of Hot Pot. JPM Super Kit, whatever you call them. Hit Money, obviously a rebuild of, I don't know, maybe Loot Shoot or something. Yeah, it could be a Loot Shoot type cab or Hot Pot. Again, original machine MPU4 Action Bank. We all know this one. One here, the other one that goes with it, although it's not next to it, is Action Pack. I believe Action Bank was the first release of the Action series, followed by Action Pack. That's what I'm led to believe. MPS2, late, very, very, very late, Rotonote. Really deep sounds machine. Not the last MPS2, but pretty much getting there. This type of cabinet. Adenote, no one seems to know this machine. High roller similarities, I guess, with the number reel and the notes. I guess it's a high roller, so I believe high roller was the last MPS machine. I guess this is the one before it, pretty close. Nice machine that, but no one seems to know it, or hardly knows it. Bank Chase, another MPS2, very late machine, dated 89, that is dated 89, so it is on the late Action Pack, as we know. Two converted, oh bloody hell, I always forget, they're JPMs, they're conversions into PCB games. So I'm trying to think for the life of me what they're called. Never mind, it doesn't really matter anyway. It is written inside them, but I've got Cash Filler, Fruit Connection. There were many others in the same sort of group, but it is nice to have two of them. I think it's quite rare to have two of them. Cash Filler, there seems that there's a, I know of a couple of Cash Fillers, I know of a couple of Fruit Connections. They are about, a lot of people seem to like these though, even though they are conversions. Anyway, it doesn't really matter, does it, as long as the games are nice. So there you go, nice little humming here. It is a nice little buzz, and it warms up quite nicely in there. And believe it or not, I've got what, 13 machines, and they all run off two sockets. I kid you not. These sort of five into that one, that leaps across to that one, which, and them two are plugged in there, and then that leaps round there and goes through the window, and it's on an extension and goes to a plug the other side. Then this plug, this side goes to that junction there, which feeds them three plugs there, which feeds them three machines there, and also the lights are fed from that, and that one and these two here are fed from the other plug. So basically I've got 2, 4, 6, 7 machines into one socket. It's never a problem. Never ever a problem, doesn't even get warm. The wire doesn't even get that little bit warm. And the six this side, because there's a door here. Otherwise I'd fit another machine in if I could, but I can't. It's literally just nice. Let's look out for space, it's absolutely perfect. It's just really nice. I can pull out each machine and turn it around, just literally, there's just enough space. So any of these machines I need to work on, or whatever I need to do, I can just get just enough room to get it out and turn it around in the middle. And you can get 2 or 3 people in here comfortably playing, and you can just squeeze past each other if you like, be a bit friendly. As you see, action pack there is over the drain, so I've made that frame for it. So that one's not on wheels. That's why it's an MPU4 on there, because you never have to touch them. So it's never needed touching. It's been sat on over that drain now for over 2 years. So the water runs underneath it from the sink in the kitchen. I kid you not. Some people have been here will know, will can testify to all this, because this was once outside, is now inside. I put these lights up ages ago. So you've got a socket, even a spare socket for your phone, and on that one. All around there, through that, that's an outside window, that goes into the kitchen, that goes into the living room, that's the outside window. So there is, I've done a few videos out here, but I know I've got some new subscribers and people are asking me, well, what machines have you got? So for those who, this is sort of, I sort of class this as my MPS room, but there's 11 MPS tech machines and two MPU4s out here. And I've got 5 MPS machines upstairs. So I have 16 MPS machines in total, I guess. And they're all okay. They all work okay. Well, I guess most of the time. I've had to repair one today. But, you know, when you've got this many in here, you expect the odd. There's many videos of these machines, but if something amazing happens, or if I feel like it, I'll just do a video of one or two of them while I'm in here today. It's a lovely buzzing noise you can hear. Yeah. That's only the MPS machines you can hear. The MPU4s are absolutely silent, don't make any noise at all. It looks nice from any angle. I should have painted the walls in here first. Even my missus said that. But I couldn't wait. As soon as it was built, machines were straight in here. I just couldn't wait. I wish I'd painted the walls now, but I can't be bothered now, to be honest. Not that you'd see. I mean, if I'd have painted just the 5 dozen courses. And the concrete floor. I have got a carpet. I had a nice carpet down in here from the old bowling alley. Fits perfect, but I had a few issues with leakages and that in here, but that's all long sorted now. The only slight leak now is where that bucket is, and any water collects down, and I've put a couple of holes in there, and any water that comes down comes through there into the bucket. It's no problem now. So obviously there's potentials for leaks, but there's no leaks anywhere else. It's absolutely bone dry in here now, and has been for about 2 years. I think that a little bit of water comes in where the Perspex is hammered onto the timber comes in through some of them studs, but it all ends up on the blue sheet, rolls down and ends up in that bucket. So quite good. So it's worked quite well. That door's hammered up, if you like. There's no, you can't get in there now. So there you go. Just thought you might like to see. So I call this my MPS room. Let me go as you come out. Hope you enjoyed that, folks. And like I say, every machine that you see on here, there is plenty of videos of them. And there's always a chance there'll be some more. It's all good fun. This is what you do when you have a day off work. I said to the missus, I'm going to go out the back and fire them all up. They haven't been on for a few weeks, so there you go. Nice room. See you in a bit. Bye.